All right, good morning, everyone.
Good morning, sir.
When do you think the class started? Yeah, and then when the bus came and then the communication started. So you really want to know that this is the kind, this is might be the nature of things you need to deal with when people in December are coming at a certain time. Okay, you cannot, see, here's the thing. What is the concern? If everybody is not accounted for, these are adults, these are committed adults. If somebody is not here when they said they would be here, you should be worried. Okay, don't take it like, must be in the bathroom or must be coming somewhere. No, absolutely not. You just want to be pakka as to where this person is and get a clear communication. Is that okay? Everybody with me? All right, so everybody's partners here except Arun now, correct? Okay, so one of the things we do, when we do these classes, especially at the departmental level, because at the level of 350 students, it gets very difficult. And it's only 1 hour lecture, so we don't have enough time to be able to deal with this. But in the evenings when we have our tutorials, especially in the way I deal with it in my department, is that we do not start the class till everybody's accounted for. Okay? And within the first two classes, people actually get that if they're going to be late, that they will communicate. So if you have communicated, then you're accounted for. You understand? So we have three groups. We have PhD students, we have MTech students, and we have MSc PhD students. So I have one person from each of the classes go up on board and write the names of the people who they don't see, because in their class they know who's not missing, right? They put the, and then if there is a communication, and by and large now what happens is, right at the beginning of the class, somebody will get up and say, sir, I have a communication for you. Yes, Vivek will not be here till 6:45. Okay, I got it. That communication is complete. Okay, so you want to set it up, by the way, and as people are coming in, it's not that, you know, at some point in time this clapping thing becomes a little bit of a funny thing or, you know, to, you know, take a make. No, that's not the intent. The intent is that they have done whatever they needed to do. How many people ever want to be late? No, we don't ever want to be late. Are we late? Yes. So what do you do in such a situation to bring integrity to the entire issue, right? You actually, when did you know that you would be late? You definitely knew 15 minutes before, 20 minutes before. Yes? Do you know a number to call where you can communicate, I'll be late? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
That's all you do. You actually call up and say, listen, I'm so-and-so, my number is so-and-so, I'm running late, I slept, overslept, I missed the bus, whatever it is. Okay? So then we know you're accounted for and then we can move on. Fair enough? There's no punishment here, there's no consequence here, it's just a matter of integrity. When you say, I'm going to be late, you made a promise to be here at 9, yes? Yes, you're not here on time, that's a broken promise. So the way you deal with the broken promise is the person you're accountable to, you call them up, communicate with them, send an SMS saying, listen, I'm running late, I'll be there at 9:20 or 9:15 or 9:10, whatever your best guess is. And then if you're not here at 9:10 as promised, you send another SMS. I think I can talk about this part for the next 2.5 hours and we'll still be able to deliver on the intent of this lecture. You with me? This is it. This is it. If we haven't dealt with this, forget about landing man on the moon or woman on the moon. Okay? A lot of work to be done today. I think some of it got done in the last 10, 15 minutes. I don't have to get into this. This is how you would deal with integrity in terms of people being late, people being absent. Don't let off. If you let off, you've actually not honoring them. Why we're running after this person is because we honor that person. Without that person, this train will not leave. Okay? So we really want to get down to business of what's going on with this person. And the person may not be well. The person may be, I don't know, what all could be going on, right? Until that person knows that, listen, that person is missed over here, he or she is not going to get, you know, the significance of being here at 9 o'clock or being in communication. I mean, I'm worried. Really, I'm worried right now. All right, so good morning and, okay. It's beginning to look a little yellow now. Okay, excellent. And I've actually said, oh, by the way, it's something in green also. You have to propose a title by September 15th. So I have some work that I've set out for you, which I'll give you by the end of this lecture, or these two lectures, the 2.5 hour session. And so then you get to create your own title. Fair enough? Yes? Okay, excellent. Anybody wants to say anything from the last session? Things are happening, churning, sleepless nights, not because of mosquitoes, but you know, some thought processes, something happening, not happening.
Yes.
Oh boy. Quiet class today, something's going on. You want me to be quiet for some time?
No.
But two, three of you have to say something, otherwise I don't get a sense of what's going on in the class. So two, three of you, how many of you are shy? No, you put your hand down, you're not shy. How many of you are shy? Shy people, please raise your hand. I just demonstrated a little earlier also, shy people will never raise their hands. Okay, human beings, raise your hand. Okay, these are all volunteers, I can pick on any one of them. Hey, you too, raise your hand, otherwise you should report any aliens around you. Any aliens around you, you should report to me. Okay, all right. So, raise your hand. Yeah, good. So you stand up. Okay, you stand up. Okay, very good. And you stand up. Okay, good. So tell me what's been going on either in the last lecture or in the, or you know, since you've been here for the last 4 days. Just brief, half a minute, not too much, okay? Just quickly.
So,
now you
last
both of
nine
you
years,
keep I let made, your heart beating yeah. fast because your turn is coming. Heart beating a little faster. Nothing. Careful, just check.
Yeah, I'm Satya from Hyderabad.
Very good.
So, since last 9 years, I'm doing some mistakes. So, after these four classes, so I'm good able to recollect what are the mistakes I'm doing, what
Excellent.
Are the commits.
Excellent.
Regarding what I feel that I'm great, okay, since I got best paper award in the UGC in the, my first lab presentation. Again, at IIC, I got best paper award. And I go on next third paper, it was published in elsewhere. And since then, I'm saying, I'm feeling that I was very great and means my presentation skills are very good.
Okay.
But after these four classes, I could able to, means I was completely silent because I'm so many things I'm making mistakes.
Wow.
So I don't want to repeat. And I'm guiding some students, okay, right from BTech level. So I want to rectify all those things.
So thank you for being generous.
Yes.
You're already a successful human being. And to be able to look to see where is it that you can grow further, I want to thank you for being generous to accept that. Okay, give
thank
him a big
you.
Hand. Fabulous, well done. Yes, my friend.
I'm Arun from Madurai, sir.
After
this class, I learned how to be humorous inside the class. That's the main thing I learned here. And I know how to be strict, but from your class, I become to know how to be humorous in the class.
Strict in the same time, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, strict comes from, see, if you're coming from a place of punishment, it's different. When you're coming from a place of honor, there cannot not be humor. We human beings are so funny. Somebody said one time, you know, God had no sense of humor. God? Somebody said, God has no sense of humor. So what are you talking about? He made human beings?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Thank you very much. Yeah, give a big hand.
Hello.
Big hand.
Sir, I am Dr. Pratibha Mahato from Kids Ramtech, that's near Nagpur. And I'm teaching the undergraduate students there as well as the PG students of MBA, that is Business Communication. And now, I did my PhD almost 25 years back, that is way back in 91, 94. Things have changed a lot since then. During this last four days, I learned a lot, which I won't be able to summarize, I believe. But specifically yesterday, when there was this one small course about how to write a paraphrase and summary writing, and at the same time, you know, how to find out the gist of it, like all three different things, like one was it was about paraphrasing and summarizing, and that a plagiarism, this one. So I really learned how it is actually to be done, like summarizing and paraphrasing. I didn't have much idea about it, the difference. Second thing, what my colleague has right said, yes, being humorous is different, but at the same time, being witty is another thing. What I taught so many times, it is how the delivery is more important than the content it becomes in the classroom. I really learned it from you, sir.
Right. So thank you for being open to receiving it. Okay. So thank you very
thank
much.
You,
okay. Appreciate it. Yeah. Very good. All right. So you should turn to your partner. Say hello, partner. And whatever these three people did, you drew with each other right away. Go ahead. Talk. Everybody clear? So whatever they said about what they had learned, you share with your partner. Go ahead. So, it's been worthwhile being here? Yes, okay, good. So you want to acknowledge yourself for that, all right? Really? Yeah? Okay, right. And you got one more day, today's day, so let's go for it, okay? Now, there's a lot of work to be done now in the next 2 hours or so, okay? So I really would want you to be on the edge of your seats, because otherwise I'll not be able to get done in 2 hours. And there's a lot at stake for me in communicating this, because if I don't communicate this, then there'll be something lost for me. My commitment is that everything that I have to be able to communicate, I want to be able to communicate, okay? Right, edge of your seats, everybody ready to go? Okay, very good. All right, so we said two things we would do, two agenda items. Tuesday, you get to work on you. And some of you got to do that a little bit, looking at your mission, looking at, you know, your concerns, your flat world, your flat earth, your fish in the water, those questions you actually looked at. And I think some of those you should continue as an inquiry for yourself, okay? The second is you get to work on designing your sessions. So I'm really want to give a lot of time today. So what we'll do is we'll have you do a personal inquiry, and then after that we will set you in groups of four, and then you design your own session. Okay, this is what I'd like to do, this is how I'd like to do it, et cetera, et cetera. So you get a feel for what it would take for you to actually deliver, if required of you, even before December. How many of you are going to go back now to your classes and your work? Yes? Most of you, right? So don't wait till December. Start experimenting. Okay? And the process would begin here. And the four of you, we would give you, you know, the four people in the group, we will make a photocopy of it, give to each one of you. There'll be email IDs, etc. So you can continue to interact with each other and so on. All right? Okay, very good. So here's what's going to be, is one of the first things you have to deal with in when you're creating a mission. How are you doing? So when you are dealing with a mission, first thing there is to deal with is willingness. I mean, I can't put somebody on a bicycle and say, now ride. You know, they have to get onto the bicycle. That willingness is there. Every time there's a desire to get off the mission. Every time, there will be a desire. How many of you already, I don't want to be in this mission? Human beings? Human beings. Yeah, human beings want to get off the, you know, mission. Why? Because there's a desire. Not enough sleep. I'm tired. We just discussed this a little while ago. That, you know, if I'm tired, what does that mean? It means I'm on a mission. See, you look at evidence, tiredness as a mission, as an evidence of something's wrong here. No, tiredness is an evidence of you're on a mission. Okay? So there'll be this desire now. And, you know, this is a very common conversation that all of us entertain. It's a joint conspiracy. 8 hours of sleep is very important. How many of you believe in that conspiracy and actually have been participating in that conspiracy? Say yes? Yeah, okay, good. You even promoted it, a minimum. Who said that? Okay, I'm not saying don't take care of your well-being, but at the same time, whatever it requires, you're up. If you're tired, you're up. If you need to get something done, you're up. And at some point in time, you go to sleep, okay? And then you wake up and you're up. Okay, so there would be desire to get off the mission. And each time, there's that desire, you will have to choose the mission. You'll have to be able to see that now the desire is choosing you rather than mission is choosing you. And in the face of that, you'll have to get bigger than both of those and choose the mission. Whatever your mission is. I don't have, what should be your mission is really you. You have to create that, okay? And this is what you have to communicate ultimately to the people that are, you know, that you're in front of. Okay, so desire will not let you stay on the mission. That's the conspiracy. Desire wants to survive. And if you choose the mission, the desire would not get the life that it wants. Okay, so you'll have to choose every time. At some point in time, in the beginning it'll be difficult. Over a period of time, it gets easier. So if once willingness is in place, what's next? Okay, I'm on a mission, I'm ready to go. What's the next thing? Articulation, sharing, and being in action. Articulation, sharing, being in action. Articulation, sharing, being in action. Get the point? This is all you have a say in. These are the only things that you have say in. Results, you have no say. You have no say in the results. The only thing you have a say in is articulation, sharing, action. At some point in time, results will begin to show up, but you're really not interested in the results. What you're interested in is articulation, sharing, action. Okay? All right, very good. Now, there is something in the way. So the first thing is fear. Everybody understands fear? Okay, and what's the second thing? Oh, some typo here. No. Oh, third thing is also fear. What is this? Everybody understand fear? Really? Okay, very good. So there are many kinds of fears, okay? So if a truck is coming and you're crossing the road and you estimate the speed and you are already halfway in the middle of the road and you experience something which is quote-unquote fear, where the heart is almost in your mouth, right? That is a real fear which is intended by design to protect you from getting hurt. Okay? But then there's this other one that's very animal, okay? There's this other one which is imaginary. I think it's imaginary. You're imagining things which actually haven't happened. And I've said many times to you that when we've done this exercise, we've always, because we thought maybe this mind and this might actually be real and all that. So one commando jeep is there and one ambulance is also there. Okay, but we've never had the need to use an ambulance. I think, you know, once people get that this is large part of it is this my own story, it kind of, you know, loses its grip on you and we've never had to use an ambulance, okay? So I should also, you know, kind of introduce you to an illusion. Everybody know what an illusion is? Okay, you know, sky is an illusion. It disappears at night. You know that, right? Sky is an illusion. The blue sky is an illusion. It disappears at night. There's an illusion called tomorrow. And you and I live it as though it's the truth. Okay? Do I say convince ho gaye or should I say more? Convince. Okay, got it. There's another illusion that human beings are addicted to. It's called certainty. You and I want to bring certainty, always. Certainty gives me a sense of safety, sense of security, sense of everything's okay, all right? And there's a very nice quotation I want to share with you. It uses the word certitude. That quotation uses the word certitude. And certitude means certainty, confidence, freedom from doubt. The synonyms are conviction, assurance, belief. So certitude basically means certainty. Okay, that you have pakka, this is how it is, this is how it should be. All right, everybody, you know, this is how it should be. How many of you know life, this is how it should be? Come on. Yeah, okay, human beings want that, we're addicted to it, okay, all right. Just get your own humanity, okay? All right, so here is the quotation. Ready? Very good. The dilemma that human beings deal with. Beautiful. Okay. How many of you at some point in time became cautious in life? Human beings?
Human beings.
All right. So I'm not saying be reckless. I'm not proposing at all to be reckless. Okay. We have responsibilities. We have things that we need to take care of. So I'm not saying be reckless. But at the same time, we've given cautious the kind of importance that it need not have. We've become too cautious. Too cautious to the point that we're not living. We need an alarm clock to wake up. So possible outcomes from this session. Everybody ready? Possible, are you? You need to know what the possible outcomes are. Okay, here we go. So possible outcomes are, who's bigger, you or your fear? Pakka. And who are you going to be now? Bigger or let the fear be bigger? You'll have to make that choice. But being cautious comes from fear, okay? So if the fear is bigger, okay, that's running the show. Okay, very good. What else could be a possible outcome? Okay. Okay. Why are we taking ourselves so seriously? Yeah? There is to communicate something, you communicate and then you laugh, right? Okay, and another outcome could be, okay, appreciation, respect, honor, and acknowledgement for yourself. So Manoj, appreciate you, respect you, honor you, and acknowledge you for doing whatever you did so that you can be here now. Okay, so thank you. You got late? Everything is okay? Okay, good. Thank you. Okay, thanks for being here. So, appreciation, respect, honor. Did you get the demonstration of that? Typically, how should I have dealt with him? Why are you late? Take him to that small room, which is soundproof room. Beat him up. Right? That's what we do. We actually have no idea what he had to deal with to be here. And, you know, we'll talk to him a little later and see whatever might be required so that if there is something that needs to be sorted out. But the fact of the matter is that he's here. Yes? Excellent. Respect, honor, and acknowledgement for... Did you time it that it was be in this slide? I think so. Did you guys play something on me? Trick pakka? Okay, good. All right. So, you know, when you begin to do that, you automatically cannot begin to, you know, you automatically begin to respect others, honor others. You begin to respect, honor, appreciate, and acknowledge life itself, and in that, the entire universe. Okay? It's that simple. Not more complicated than that. So everybody ready? On the court work now? Do that, everybody. Like that. Okay? Ready. Okay, good. So this is the ticket details that I had given last time. And what we had said we would do is review one journal paper in your area of interest, okay? Prepare 5 slides to communicate the essence of the paper, all right? Prepare 1 slide with a question for a quiz to the audience, total 5 minutes. Bring the PPT on a pen drive at the next class, which is today, and be ready to present, you know, like in a dress code, like you wear something. This dress code thing, I said formal one time, and then some people came dressed up like they were going for a wedding or something. Ghagra cholis and sherwanis and all that. I said, what is this, you know? So you come dressed like you would come for an interview, okay? So we don't need to deal with that here. We're dealing with professionals. But for students, you need to deal with that because they sometimes would come in their chappals and shorts and stuff like that, okay? So you need to deal with that. So how many of you know that you have followed all these instructions? So if you have followed these instructions, raise your hand. Okay? You didn't follow? Which instruction you didn't follow?
Thanks.
Thank you.
Okay, that's okay. So you chose a paper which you have a doubt whether it is fulfilling on this condition.
Yeah.
But you still did the rest of the work.
Yeah.
Rest of the
I tried.
No, the trying, I think we've demonstrated trying, right? No, I'm not. Does it say be satisfied somewhere? Where does it say satisfied? I mean, if you were satisfied, I wouldn't be needed here. My job is to beat you up so that you get satisfied. Right? So, this one over here, fulfilled? Okay. So, if you reviewed one journal paper, everybody did that? Okay, good. Prepare 5 slides to communicate the essence of the paper, yes? Yes? Okay, good. Did you prepare 1 slide with a question for the quiz to the audience that they could answer from the 5 slides? Yes? Yes, everybody? Okay, you didn't. What happened? So see, there's no trying thing. You did something or you didn't do something. Let's be very, yeah.
No, I didn't do the question part, sir.
You didn't do the question part and you didn't do it because?
No, I really forgot about that actually.
Got it, okay. So you forgot, right? So you therefore, if you go by this, then you don't have a valid ticket, correct? Okay, good, no problem. Typically when this happens in the class, there are some 350 students in the class and I go one step at a time and by the end of the class, I have only 30 people left. Okay, it's actually an exercise in human beings following instructions. Human beings are not designed to follow instructions. Human beings are designed to do what their mind says over and above the instruction. Okay, so, and I think I told you about the parachute packing.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, so, and you know, if you don't take the instructions of how to pack the parachute, you'll be going down in gravity free fall and blaming who? It doesn't matter who you blame. Okay, all right, good. So, okay, so got it. So that's what happened. And does that happen once in a while? It's a human thing for you? You forgot? But it was written, huh? How many of you prepare checklists? Okay, how many of you follow? You even forget that you have to follow. So in fact, one of the things on the checklist is see the checklist. All right. Okay, total 5 minutes. 5 slides to present 5 slides. How much time did it take? So, you know, I'm saying that now I'm giving you the audience for 5 minutes. There are the 5 slides. Present the 5 slides in 5 minutes. Did you time it?
Yes, yes, that has been done.
It's been done?
Yes.
Was it 5 minutes?
5 minutes.
Huh.
Because you have given the instructions that it should
I know,
be
but not 4 minutes, 59 seconds?
That exactly.
The hand of this, where does it not say? It says 5 minutes! You know, when the aircrafts are landing, you know what's the gap between 2 aircrafts landing in a busy airport?
Yes.
It's not 5 minutes, by the way. No, lesser. Lesser, it's seconds in the resolution of seconds, okay? 10 seconds, 15 seconds, 20 seconds, that's the kind of level it is, okay? So there you can't say, not exactly. Whatever, no? Okay,
yes.
So how many of you actually timed it to the second? Or you said, oh, the resolution is, maybe my mistake, I should put 5:00:00. Maybe that will give you the resolution, because most engineers, scientists, we deal with resolutions, right? So because I said 5 minutes, so your resolution was plus minus 1 minute. My watch is only giving me, there are no seconds watch, seconds hand over here. So when it is 4 minutes, also okay. When it is 6 minutes, also okay, because the resolution is 1 minute. Is that how it happened? Say yes. So you didn't follow the instruction, so please sit down. If you didn't follow that instruction, please sit down. 5 minutes? I love it. Usually this is the time when negotiations begin to happen. Okay, when the person will say, you know, but I worked so hard, let me at least defend this, Nayar. At least let me try. You go to the ticket counter and say, you know, the traffic jam at Kanjurmarg, that's why I couldn't come on time. And the guy says, I can't help you, sir, the flight has already taken off. 5 minutes? You didn't do what? Timing of the 5 minutes. So invalid ticket. Sit down. No problem. No, 4 minutes, 59 seconds? 5 minutes, 3 seconds? No, but did you practice it so that it was 5 minutes? No, no, you prepared for 5 minutes or you were prepared to present it in 5 minutes?
Initially, it's prepared to present in 5 minutes. And I tried, it initially took 8 minutes, then again 6 minutes, sometime it took 4 minutes. And I hope if I try, I may.
Very nice. So that's really straight and honest. I worked on it, it was 8 minutes first, and I did the next time, it was 4 minutes. I'm just hoping actually right now that it'll be a valid ticket. Correct?
Yes.
I got it, no problem, but that's where it is. It's not to the point like I can put my life on it that it's going to be 5 minutes.
No.
Okay, got it. Okay, but that's what I'm inviting you to. You start dealing with it that way, your whole being is going to shift. Okay, very good. Okay.
We didn't test it actually for 5 minutes.
What did you test it for?
Yeah, practiced it for.
You practiced it for 5 minutes and say, enough, I'm showing it.
No. I'm saying that I didn't practice, but I have prepared 5 slides and I'm very confident that I can present it in 5 minutes. Like that, I have prepared.
If my life depended on it, would you still do it?
No.
Say no.
No.
Okay, good. No problem. See, there's no problem with it. It's just you got to get straight about it. Listen, by the way, I also want you to know, when there's 350 students, okay? And at the end, only 30 people are left. By the way, each time this thing happens with each instruction, I just say, thank you very much. You have an invalid ticket. Go home. Okay? And of course, nobody wants to go home. It's like, come on, I came for the class. You know, at least give me. So we actually have the attendance also outside. Because they're human beings. Yeah, they do whatever they do. But I've come here at 8:15 in the morning. Give me my attendance. Of course, I'll give you your attendance. I have no problem. Why? Because a few slides later, I had said appreciation, respect, honor, and acknowledgement for you. I will honor them for coming. But do they have a valid ticket? They don't. Do they have a parachute that's packed up properly? No. I'm not going to have them free fall in gravity. This is dangerous territory. Now, I say in a bad way, dangerous territory, but if you were a surgeon and you had to practice that procedure to finish in 5 minutes, because 5.5 minutes, the oxygen in the blood drops and the person is going to die, you better get it down to 5 minutes. And I think the first slide that I showed you, in the first or the second or third slide I showed you, we are doing brain surgery here. Okay? All right, excellent. So thank you for acknowledging it. Okay, no problem.
So actually, it took for me 4 minutes and odd seconds, but it was not exactly 5 minutes. But I'm confident that I can sandwich with a few nanoseconds of silence in between.
And also trust that God will save this person sitting on the third. And what if it went a little beyond 5 minutes?
Then I can cut short the nanoseconds of silence.
Okay, the only thing I'm going to request you is to don't be so certain.
Yeah.
When you're not so certain, life shows up differently. If you can take on, man, I really don't do this, I don't know how to do this, I should practice a little more, a few more times. Why? Because somebody's life depends on it. By the way, you should know. Do you know why I'm standing here? What makes me say what I say? Because your life depends on what I say right now. Everybody with me?
Yes.
And don't take it lightly. You should just know I will not take it lightly. I do not take it lightly, because your life does depend. When you step out of here, you want to be left with certain things so that you don't require me. And the quality of your life is totally going to be in your hands. So therefore, I'll be willing to be wrong, but I'm not going to say something which I can't then be responsible for. Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay? Invalid ticket. This is very cool now. Invalid. Invalid. See, you can't be hung for more than, one time for one crime, right? Ek baar latka diya, okay, invalid ticket, I'm going to go home, right? By the way, I let people keep sitting till they see each and every, because there could be more than one reason for having an invalid ticket, okay? So people need to get what they... By the way, the one that really people go out for is chappals. Chappals, wearing chappals, okay? They'll wear, bathroom chappals and come. I mean, you can't go for an interview like that, yeah? You set it up that way. But you want to be responsible, especially, jeans, for example. Jeans are considered to be formal. But in an international kind of an environment that we are dealing with in our country, jeans are not formal, okay? People wear T-shirts. It's a collared T-shirt, that's fine. Oh, by the way, my favorite one is, and this always, works out. I say, and some people actually go and buy new chappals and new shoes for this They do. They do. Sometimes I even tell them, borrow from someone your shoe size. But come prepared, because if your life's going to depend on it, then you better be doing whatever it takes. I may not have the money, but I have friends around. Okay? And the most popular brands of chappals, by the way, is Woodlands. You know, so I usually say, is it Woodlands? Huh, sir, Woodlands. I said, out. Woodlands, I bought Woodlands yesterday. I spent a lot of money on it. I got it. Yeah, but chappals are not allowed. Okay? But that's something you work it out with them. It's again inside of what? All of this. Nothing that you're saying, nothing that's coming out of your mouth is anything but this. Okay, everybody with me? Yes? Okay, excellent. So please, those of you who have done the work on it, please stand up again, including invalid tickets. Please stand up. By the way, do you know everybody was invalid ticket? Everybody? Everybody's ticket is invalid? All of humanity is in this room. By the way, do you think this is a difficult exercise? Say yes. It's a very difficult exercise, okay? It's not intended for you to pass. It's not about failing also. But if you see that you couldn't do it, it actually opens up a new chapter in how you could possibly be dealing with your preparation. And that's what my invitation is. Okay, very good. And you know, 4 minutes, what you said, nanosecond, I agree with you, you know. At some point in time, you get enough skills to be able to fit the same thing in a shorter time, or you know, if you need to extend it, you can extend it depending on how the surgery is going. Okay, but for that, you've got to do a lot of work, a lot of practice. Okay, that's so I'm inviting you to the practice of it. Okay, I don't have the answers, by the way. You understand? Okay, somebody taught me also. You understand, right? Okay, good. I'm still learning. Okay, good, very nice. Okay, all right, good. So now, one of the volunteers, please come on stage to give the talk. How come you didn't come up? No, you don't have to come up now, but how come when I said volunteer, how come you didn't come up? I know, but why was you not the one? Oh, yeah, okay, fine. So you're off the hook. You didn't prepare. I got it. So just you should definitely sit down. Sit down. Yeah, okay, good. How come you didn't come?
Yeah, our company is in the same
center. No, but you didn't come up. How come you didn't come here? When I said, I gave enough time, right? I said, one person come up. These two people came, a little reluctantly, but they came. Right? You didn't, actually, you came and left it here, right? And then.
I was waiting for that. You mentioned.
Huh?
Yeah,
it's
one
call.
So I was
expecting,
okay, you call me.
Where is this?
Yeah, it's
so I said, no, one of the volunteers come. How come you were not the one? No. I'm not playing a trick on you. I'm really not playing a trick on you. Seriously, okay? Where does it say which one? Whatever it is that was there, how come you didn't come?
Yeah, I was there.
Yeah. Sorry? So your invalidity of the ticket is, you know, all permeating. Okay, very good. Okay, so why don't you guys sit down on the chair, because I got some talking to do. You know, we're not going to give the presentation. You know that, right? Sit. No, there isn't enough time for me to do that. I just wanted to demonstrate something, okay? By the way, you should know that these 6-7 people are the people who volunteered. What were the rest of you doing yesterday on Tuesday? How come you didn't volunteer? Okay, laptop ko excuse. How many people have laptops and didn't volunteer? Yeah, how come? Okay, what have we been dealing with? Yeah, somewhere you, all of this, right? Okay, all of this we've been dealing with, right? Okay, let's keep moving forward. So for most of you, it was a relief. How many of you are happy that these two guys? Human beings, so funny you are. Okay, so you know, a lot of you, thank God I was not called. And of course, your faith in God is totally restored now. And some of you were praying, you know, that you didn't get, I'm telling you, yeah. And you know, people say, you know, you don't believe in God. Of course God exists. Okay, so the experience before this relief is often referred to as? And what do you think your students deal with? Okay, so to the degree that you would be willing to step up is the degree to which they'd be willing to step up. Okay, you just got to have compassion for human beings being totally dominated by fear. You just want to. So we actually do this in the class. In fact, I've done it slightly differently. What I do in the class is I actually have a roll number appear. It's a fictitious roll number. Okay, and I usually have one of my PhD students who is not in the course, who has seen this exercise before, come and sit over here. And when that person, that roll number comes, and the way I do the roll numbers is in suspense, like typical Bollywood movie. Each letter, no, with animation, comes turning like this, like this, like this. So they don't know. They see the one, and they see the two, and they see the three. And if it's no five over there, main bach gaya. Okay, so when you do that, the number finally comes and everybody's now looking who's the person, and then my PhD student stands up and there's 350 people, so they really don't know whether this person is really from their class or from a previous class kind of situation. Works out very well. And so then this person gets up and I say, okay, please give every, and then I start this entire process of saying, how many of you? So 348 class people in the class. So 348 minus one with a star with that roll number, 347 are experiencing relief now. Okay, so everybody, so guys, thank you. Now these guys are feeling, what is all this drama, all the work that I did? How was it? How was the exercise of preparing the slides? Was it good?
Actually, one more friend, Mr. Agaretti and Nagarjuna, we three spent more than 3 hours. And I have finalized everything in the morning at 5 o'clock.
Yeah.
It's a very first experience. This is my first experience. I never done like this. I mean, so far I made around more than 20 less, but it is very difficult to make it 5 slides.
So should we have him present?
Yes. Yes.
No, this is appreciation, nahi. This is something else here. Okay, good. So we'll let him present. Chalo. Give him a big hand, everybody. You want to go say hello to them, introduce yourself, and I know you've said a few things already, but say some things, but not about the presentation. And who's going to be my timer? Who? Two people. I need one there and one there. Okay, so when do you want a time signal? 4 minutes and 30 seconds? Or 4 minutes?
5 minutes.
Then it'll be over, yaar.
Okay.
You understand?
4 minutes, 4 minutes.
You understand this, the usefulness of this?
Yes.
Okay. All right, so when I say close your eyes, that's when 1 minute will begin. Okay? You'll see this, yeah. Don't worry about it. Right now, I want you to experience how long 1 minute is. Everybody ready? Okay, very good. So please close your eyes. Thank you. Please open your eyes. Yeah. See, so a lot of times, if you have a 5 minute presentation and now you have only 1 minute left, a lot of times people try and fit 5 minutes in 1 minute. You don't need to. It can take 10 seconds, 15 seconds to even look at, okay, I have 45 seconds to go. What is it that I really want to communicate? And then actually those 15 seconds, you can design the next 45 seconds of your communication. Okay, so 1 minute is a long time. Okay, so I'll give you, where's my friend? Okay, I'll give you 1 minute warning.
Yes.
After 4 minutes, I'll give you warning. So you're going to be keeping my time. So at the end of 4 minutes, you'll say what? No. You can't say four and then this guy's wondering who's coughing over there. Right? Or you can't say, you know, last 1 minute now, please rise. The honorable judge is coming. No, you can't do that also. Okay. So you'll say cuckoo. rehearsal, yeah. Okay. At 4 minutes. Okay, once we say start, okay? Okay, good. Well, one more person from you, one more bird. So you'll go peep, peep. Excellent. So both of you have to be synchronized, otherwise there's trouble. I don't care, but if you go 1 second early or 1 second later, then make sure you keep going cuckoo, 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 then he goes peep, peep. Yeah, this guy, as always, is confused. I mean, what are my two times? Am I landing or am I not landing? All right, very good. So what's your name?
Satya.
Satya, okay, good. So please welcome Satya. So Satya, 5 minutes, five slides, and after that we will do one. You have the quiz slide also?
Yes.
Excellent. All right, starting now. So 1, 2, 3, now.
Good morning, friends. So what made me to work on this project? Just a small idea started from kitchen room. That's it. So when I'm boiling, milk, right? So boiling on cooker, okay, means on the gas stove, it is taking some time. But the same thing when I'm doing using microwave, fine, it is taking within just 1 minute like that. So the once when my wife asked just what is the mechanism that why it is making fast. That idea, okay, means I had gone through something, I don't know, frankly. That made me to work on this project, which I'm already working since 2 years, extraction of biodiesel from various sources by normal conventional method. Then I use this method using microwave technique, and I can't able to work this with the final year students because I need some time. For that purpose, just I selected some students which I'm handling with first year itself, I need some time to adjust and everything. And we started with first year, and during the summer vacation of their first year, okay, Mr. Rohan and Mr. Junaid, who are my mechanical year students, so then we made working.
Okay.
So what is the main objective? Okay, how micro oven heating technique is better than conventional heating, and the same thing purpose which I'm using for, okay, normal in a chemistry lab, okay, for any normal reactions. What is the hypothesis? Reaction time may be reduced in production of biodiesel, what happened in the kitchen room, that's it, in boiling the milk, right? And because of this, when I'm going for large-scale manufacturing, right, in extraction and anything, what will happen? Save energy, and it may, okay, the cost of producing biodiesel will be very less. That is the hypothesis what I made. Now, what is the basic reaction, what is happening in the conventional method, okay? So first, what is the raw material used for biodiesel extraction? Raw material is again, okay, edible oils and non-edible oils. It is very expensive. So for that purpose, what I selected is a used cooking oil. So most of you are using the oils, okay, while cooking. Again, it will be used for another summative, okay? But what is happening, okay? What is happening means it is producing some free radicals, and that radicals will mix with some cells, and it is causing some carcinogenic diseases, which is almost a cancer type. So I selected this as a raw material. Then how to get it? So what is in Hyderabad is very famous for biryanis, yes, and fries and everything. So I sent some of my students to the different restaurants and collected the sample. That is my raw material. And instead of I purchased it as a 15 rupees per liter. So that is my raw material. And I cannot use that raw material directly for this. First, I should do some pre-processing like filtering. Okay, next, I should identify what is the acid content. And next, I should use what catalyst. Catalyst, there are different types of catalysts are there for initiating the reactions. Acid catalyst and base catalyst are there. Again, actually, because these are handled by just first year engineering students, okay, came from just in it, so I selected as base catalyst. That is the only reason. And I should calculate some basic reactions are there, which I have done, and all the things. And reactions regarding downstream process, how to create that reactor. Fine. So I cannot bring that micro one directly. And so what I done is, I purchased one, just a micro oven from scrap. It costs around 500. Fine. What was the experimental setup? So this was the experimental setup what we designed. And for that, okay, that was the glass reactor what we made, and the condenser, everything. And coming to the same thing, real food, this is the real thing what we made it. This is the real thing, okay? So that was the micro oven, which is of just a used one, and we made it into work it and complete setup. So what is the basic mechanism? Most of you, we are having that micro oven in the home, right? What is happening? So it is not, there is no external heating, but, okay, it is, because of the vibration, it is generating heat. because of the vibration it is generating, vibrating molecule, it is generating heat. That is, okay, heating, boiling the from inside. So for that, okay, so much energy can be consumed and can be done within very less time. Normal heating, it is taking around 1 hour. With the process, I can be able to complete within 20 minutes. So what are the results and conclusion? Okay, so because after all the reactions, what will happen? So with the help of this, okay, from 1 hour, it made into 20 minutes. And I compared these results with the petrol diesels, normal diesels. So what is the conclusion, next please? So reaction time was reduced by 65% in the production of biodiesel. Cost of the production of biodiesel is reduced by 40%. Then we practically proved this one. And we made, okay, so normal diesel cost is around 60, like that. And with the help of this, we could able to make around 40 rupees. So this is my team, what we given live demonstration recently. And these are in our second year. And coming to what are the applications, and we taken this oil and tested in the generator also in our camp, which is a DSC what they are doing. And we got very good results by using the blended oils also. Fine. So any question? Okay. Coming to the questions.
No,
okay.
Stop. So are you done?
Yes.
Okay, good. So how many minutes?
6 minutes, 6 seconds.
So, how many times do I have to shoot him? No need. I like that. Very generous people. I'm going to shoot him anyway because I'm going to shoot you in the process. Okay, so thank you for doing that. Give him a big hand. Okay, excellent. Good job. Now, do you know that after 4 minutes you really accelerated?
Yeah.
Thank you for the... Very well. You were so well timed, I'm telling you, yeah. And I couldn't figure out whether both had happened or not because it happened in the same instant. So what is your experience? So just go a little further away so that we can talk. And I want to be here so that you can actually see the audience as we're talking. So what is the experience for you? How was it?
So actually I'm having the experience, okay, different experience in presentation anything, but this time I followed a scientific method.
Okay.
So previously I didn't follow, okay. Same thing I presented in JNU Delhi some few months back, okay, different, but it was around 25 slides and it was given time is just 8 minutes.
Okay.
But I felt that, okay, I could not able to reduce more than this 25 slides. But because after following all these 4 years experience, okay, with the help of this, okay, Agarati and Agarjuna, we tried and it's like brainstorming, we made it to 5 slides.
You know it's not 5 slides.
No, which one?
These are not 5 slides.
Five?
No.
Five,
you
and
know,
one, what, sixth question
you know
is
what is
slide.
Going on? Eight. When you were doing this, everybody is counting the number of slides.
Okay. Yeah, I mean. So yes. 5 slides, presentation,
no,
one
no.
question.
No. That is not the instruction.
Right.
Instruction was, hey, stop, you guys. He's here. You can't say anything. You're not here. Shh, quiet. Okay. So it is not, you'll have to acknowledge that it's not 5 slides.
Yes.
It's invalid ticket.
Yes.
For this reason also.
Yes.
Okay. There may be other reasons for this reason also.
Okay. Yes.
Where's the quiz question? Quiz question.
Quiz,
yeah. Did you make that slide?
Yes.
Shh, shh, shh.
Yeah.
No, hold on. So you expect these people to answer these questions after having listened to your last 6 slides?
I can. Yes, I'm trying. They
you what are you? You're going
they can,
to kill
I
your
can,
students?
They can. I think.
You can?
Yes. I will make
Listen.
You. I'll make you.
No. You can't make. It's over. Five right. minutes is over. See, the point is this. Everybody getting this? Okay. The point is, no, the entire design is that in those 5 slides, and there are too many questions. I actually wanted you to only give one question, right? Which they'll be able to answer based on the 5 minutes and 5 slides that you have shown. So what you're really doing, this, by the way, this is not just you, everybody. How many people are getting that? The whole idea has been that in 5 slides and 5 minutes, you're able to communicate the essence of a paper such that the audience can answer one quiz question. Okay? So I'm even going to assert to the next level. Design the quiz question first. After having read the paper, design the quiz question first and then design your 5 slides to lead up to the answer of that question. No, I don't think so. How many people can answer this question? Raise your hands. that's okay. So, but no, the point is all of them are there. So don't, let's not split it up. He intended you to answer all these questions. Okay, so how many of you can answer? Now you've got to really look, because this has got, this is the moment of truth here.
Yes.
Okay, so how many people can answer, can pass this quiz? You can't see? I love it. I can't even see the question, you know, so forget it. Right? That's okay, I got it. Okay, but up beyond that row, you're exempt from the exam. This side of the rows, okay, how many of you? So you really want to get this, okay? It doesn't matter what you said or you didn't say. They are not going to pass this exam. You're a tough examiner.
Yes, it's a tough exam.
Huh? Tough, no? It's a tough exam. But see, listen, you know, the so it's not that they failed, okay? It's I failed in my communication. That's the place where you need to stand. So keep practicing, okay? You want to send me, which paper is this, by the way?
It's published in January.
Sure, go to the first slide. Okay, very good. So if this is your work, right? Your work, your published work, right? It'd be good to give the reference, because it's okay if you are presenting your own paper, no problem. It's just that you want to give that reference because you are reviewing it for them. So anything else for you? So do you know you failed?
Yes.
Okay,
I'm
excellent.
Accepting. I'm accepting. Huh? I'll accept. I'm failed.
I mean, whether you accept or not, the fact is what? But you really want to know that it takes courage to say that, yeah, I failed. I'm telling you this, okay, Satya, most of the people in this room are successful people. Most of the people in this room are successful. Or let me say it another way. All people in this room are successful. That's why they're here. Okay? But I'm now calling you on a mission.
Yes.
So if I'm calling you on a mission, you'll begin to find out things that you're not going to be successful because it's the first time you're getting onto the bicycle. The game is different. It matters now whether they can answer the quiz question or not. If they cannot answer the quiz question, then I didn't do my job. Everybody with me? All right, so you know, and it's not failure. It's not failure in the way that we think, I failed. No, not like that. Oh, I failed. Okay, let's start again. This is the time, by the way, also, when you need to learn to laugh at yourself. Satya? This is the time you say, man, I fell down. But you know what? You're the only person here of the 119, 118, I don't know what the count is right now, who's up here? Who actually stepped up and say, I'm going to do it. Who worked 3 hours at night and actually worked on it so that everybody else would get benefited. And I also acknowledge the other people who prepared, the volunteers. Please stand up. Please stand up, my volunteers. Yeah, okay. Somebody else who's, yeah, okay. So, you know, you guys did the work so that we could actually have this conversation, and I appreciate it. And I bet you that each one of you would have come up here, you would have failed. That was my job, by the way. Not because I want you to fail. But even if you did the best of job, I'll still find some gap where you need to grow. That's what the coach would do, right? Otherwise, what's my job here? Okay? Now, there's some obvious things over there. One obvious thing is that you need to be able to say what the journal is, which article, which journal, which year, all that stuff. You need to make sure that it's 5 slides, including photographs, including references. If you think it is important to show photographs, it has to be within 5 slides. If you have to show references, it has to be within 5 slides. That's the game we have set up. You go back and you set up a new game with your students. That's up to you. I've just created this 5 slides game for us here. You can create it any way you want. If you think that 10 slides will be able to do it, I can bet you there'll be an 11th slide. So it's not about 5 slides being too little, it's just about not following the instructions. Not a bad thing. Don't want to take it wrongly, don't want to take it I say it badly, but the intent is that, the point is that instruction was not followed. So instead of making a 2-inch cut into the brain, you said another 1/2 inch doesn't matter. It matters. Are you doing brain surgery here?
Yes.
There you go. So your whole role now as a surgeon, as a brain surgeon, is completely a new game. Are you practiced at it? No, you're not. Are you invited? Absolutely. So give him a big hand, and all these guys, big hand, all right? Good job. Take your, Okay, very good. Thank you very much. Okay, thanks a lot. Thanks for playing. Thank you very much. Okay, thank you. Okay, good. Now, some of you are saying, how many of you would want to do this exercise when you get back? Everybody's hand should be up, otherwise I'm coming to your home. All right, so you should take it on. Take it on with your colleagues, okay, not with students. Take it on with your colleagues and say, listen, I'm going to cover. Now, I'll tell you a very interesting part of it. If one person did one paper, how much time would you spend on it? About 2 hours? Okay, 2 hours. And then 6 of you get together over a cup of tea. Each one of you take 5 minutes for the presentation and 5 minutes for question answers or quiz or whatever, right? In 1 hour, you would have listened to how many papers? 6 papers. So when you're doing this presentation, when you're making it, you're actually doing it inside of service. I spend 2 hours so that other person can get benefited in 5 minutes. And similarly, if 6 people do it and come together for a cup of tea or coffee in 1 hour, you actually share that with each other. Completely changes how you actually work with each other. Okay, so I'm inviting you to that as well. Okay? Yes? Okay, excellent. All right, so everybody okay with this? How many of you came to get trained, but FAIR will not let you get trained? Raise your hands. Everybody? Yeah. So my neighbor, train this person. I'm okay, I'll watch. Okay, we're always waiting for somebody else to get trained around. So then this is some work which we will do. We will do after the tea break. Okay, everybody? Okay, now before we go, give me one more minute. I know it's 10:31 right now, but give me a minute. Somebody, one person from here, one person from here, one person from here, take the microphone and tell me what is it that you got out of this entire exercise. One person, volunteer here, please. Volunteer here, one person. Come. All right, quickly. Let's quickly, what happened, what you learned, what you got out of being here this morning?
I'm Shankar Kumar from Coimbatore.
Turn around, talk to people. Yeah.
The lessons we have learned from
Not
this...
Not we.
I learned from this session is how to design my own lesson or action plan, okay, whenever I do prepare for my coursework.
Fabulous, yeah.
And the second thing is about I try to communicate myself that I can also prepare in such a way that I can articulate my lecture and I have shared it, then I can really make everybody to work on it. So this is the typical course plan which I can design for each session throughout my career.
Well done. Well done. Yeah, thank you for doing that. Yeah.
Hello, sir. This is Mahesh from Kolhapur, KIT's College of Engineering, Kolhapur. What I've learned from this session is the bigger hindrance between we as a presenter and the student is the fear. What we generally do, we prepare.
By the way, where is that fear?
That is inside, within us.
Where? Surgeons have not found it yet.
Yeah, that is the mental one. It's mental.
Okay, got it. Okay.
Yeah, so if we just avoid, we could overcome that, it is not that much difficult.
You'll never be able to overcome it. Everybody, let's get clear. The more you try and overcome it, the more it will be.
Okay.
So you can't overcome it. You'll have to accept it, hold it, embrace it, kiss it, love it.
That is, go with the fear.
Yeah. Thank you, fear. Thank you for being here. You serve a purpose. Thank you. Okay, now what's to be done? Oh, you're still here. Happy. Right? Come. Okay, so this is another illusion. That we will overcome. You know, there will be one time when you will overcome your fear. I don't need to say it. You understand, right? Everybody? Okay, good. Human beings, yes? Yes? Okay, you understand. Okay.
And about the presentation, Saki, we have to be very strict about the timelines. That if it is, we are given 30 minutes or 40 minutes.
You don't have to be. Students are sitting, they will jello it. Students are very generous. Somehow they'll say, okay, sir, whenever sir will finish, that's when the lecture will end.
But that is to avoid this, because instead of getting burden on the students,
excellent,
if we could finish.
Excellent. So you're really serving them, right? You're out to serve them.
Yes.
So keep saying, I'm sorry, I keep interrupting you. Keep going.
No, it's on. That is only, we have to finish within the time so that students will learn what actually we want them to learn. Instead of going beyond our time, it will not work at all.
Fabulous. Very well done. Very well said. Okay, next please. Yeah.
So what I've gathered is we have to accept shortcomings and our capabilities we have to identify, and together with it we have to train our mind in such a way so that the fear factor, which works in everyone's mind, is obviously, as you said, should be there, but at the same time taking the best out of it by not being risk averse for the basic thing of failing, like every human mind. So despite having this attitude, in Hindi, I would love to coin that word, dekha jayega.
Yeah,
that is good. It gives you the
chalta hai, feeling.
No, let us see. I mean, I'm taking a risk. Yeah. And yes, I may fail. And if I fail, there should be a B plan or something like that.
Yeah.
And despite that,
suddenly
I will
become cautious. Eh?
Yeah. No, but then cautious factor has to be that.
Cautious.
But sir,
cautious.
But sir, recklessness, recklessness is also there.
Did I say don't be cautious?
Yes.
All I'm saying is cautious.
Yeah, but
and you don't defend. I'm not attacking.
Okay, sir. Fine, sir.
Or you just, human beings, you know, that thought comes in, but you just got to see, I am getting cautious. That's all.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Yeah, sure.
No, I appreciate it. Yeah. Listen, I'm very cautious.
And being the greatest risk in life, I feel, with my own experience, is not taking the risk at all.
Yeah.
And I would like, I really appreciated this last line, like, being risk averse is death, actually. You never achieve something, anything, and you are a flat, I mean, your life goes this way.
Fabulous.
Yeah, this is what. And so another thing that I really appreciate in you, this 1 minute factor, because I personally, I'm a devotee of Sri Ramakrishna, so we do this meditation, you know. So when I go to the mutt and sit in Belur mutt, so I feel what is 1 minute, because they have a watch there.
Yeah.
And which goes
fabulous, right?
It gives you that feel that, yes, the day consists of 24 hours.
Yeah.
Yes, I am a human being. I have an opportunity. And yes, I can do lots.
Very well said. Very well said. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much for being generous. So three of you, please stand up. So stand up. And where's my person here? Okay, stand up. So please, everybody give them a big hand.